This is Peter with PM Design here. In this video, I want to quickly talk to you about the Pose library and show you how it can be beneficial if you haven't already used it. First thing I do want to say though is I'm sorry to my few subscribers. I've been busy, very busy recently. I haven't uploaded in a while. I've been working on a little solo project, which is currently now rendering, as you can see. It's killing my computer. I've only got like another 1,000 frames to render or something like that. So sorry to those subscribers, I haven't uploaded for a while. Anyway, so the Pose library. I've got my MetaRig here. This is a MetaRig which I have fully, well, I've IK'd it a lot. You've got IK legs, IK arms, and IK fingers. You might think the fingers are a bit unnecessary, but you'll find out why in a little while. So the Pose library is over here. You'll find it, if you haven't used it before, you go here, you add a new one. And so what I've done is I've given him lots and lots of poses, well not lots, I could give more. Because then when I want to animate it later, it's really easy, I don't have to mess around with these poses. So just for example, you could do a walk cycle. Yeah, so I've got the three base poses there, and then to continue the walk cycle, I go back to contact one, copy that pose and paste X flipped, and then it's flipped it across. Yeah, and then I just repeat, go back to this one, control C or right click, paste X flipped, and I could just make a walk cycle like that. What I focus on mainly is the hands, because you know when you're animating you don't want to keep on changing the hands over and over again, so I try to think of some of the more common hand poses which we might have. So if I just get right in there, you can see we've got hand semi-relaxed, hand relaxed, hand gun, which just means, you know, like pretending he's holding a gun with the fingers, like a karate chop or whatever, pinch, you know, like he's pinching something or picking up some, you know, a grain of salt, whatever. So this is the advantage of doing that, because then you just click that, and so if you put that on one frame and then you put the other one, or put another one on a few frames later, it will animate between those, it will interpolate between those. So I'm just going to show you how to do one quickly, just in case you don't know how this works. I would isolate the hand just to make it easier, but I'm going to keep the whole model here because I want to show you something important. So what we're going to do, we're going to make a peace sign. So it's probably easier, just for the sake of this video, to keep it quick. I'm going to start off with the fist. And then I'm going to grab my fingers, the two fingers that I want to make the peace sign with. And you know, obviously this might take you a little bit longer if you don't have the IK, but you'll see why I do the IK, because then you just go wow like that. Isn't that cool? And I just like to rotate them up because it looks nice. And then I'm going to bring that one down, and that's it. I've got a kind of peace sign going on, yeah, with the thumb folded in. That's why I chose the fist. Right, so very important, when you're building the pose library, you have to only select the bones which you want to be added as that pose. If you were to select all of these and add that into the pose library, then that pose will save as all of those bones. So I only want these. Yeah, I can also include my poles. Okay, then you just go over to here, add new, and we call it hand piece. All right. So now if I just change the hand, if I just change back to another one, I don't know what that one is. Open intent. Okay. And now I've got that one saved in there. And if I wanted to put that across on the other side, I just paste X flipped. Oh, what's happened here? Sorry. Go back over here. Oh, I forgot to IK these, so it might not work. Oh well. Let's see what happens. Yeah, it didn't work because I didn't IK them. Ho ho ho, silly me. Anyway, I didn't IK that hand yet. Anyway, so you could just paste it over to that side, and then you could go back to this one, and well, you don't even need to select. Actually, we go for fingers crossed, and you'll keep that pose that you set over there, and you can change back to this one. Okay, so if you found that useful, apart from my little fumble there where I haven't actually IK'd this hand yet, haven't finished IK'ing it. If you found that useful, please drop a like, and once again, sorry to my subscribers for the delay on uploading. Thanks very much.